Today, I'm going to teach you guys on how to examine the inguinal hernia. Okay, usually in inguinal hernia, bear in mind that the instruction that will be given to you is to examine the inguinal region. Okay, the moment you come to the room, you see the examiner, and examiner will say, among the instruction that will be given to you, they will say that this gentleman coming with inguinal swelling or swelling over the scrotal region. So please examine the patient's groin. So the moment you listen to the cue, to the instruction, you know that at the back of your mind, this is something related to the inguinal region or inguinal pathology. Okay, among the example, differential diagnosis, it can be inguinal hernia. It can be hydrocele, it can be testicular tumor, it can be varicocele. But usually varicocele, not much of a swelling, but they can complain of what? Infertility. Or the first time fertility is primary infertility. Okay? So you need to hear the cue. Okay, usually in exam, the patient can be in sitting position or is already on the bed. There are two situations. The first one, big swelling, complete type of inguinal hernia. Another one is bubonosyl or funicular type, very small. Meaning that if patient lie flat on the bed, you can't see anything. Okay, if the first option, if you see that cue just now, instruction, what should you do is you immediately you ask permission, and then you immediately bring down the pen until the mid thigh. Encik, saya Dr. Muhammad Firdaus. Saya ingin membuat pemeriksaan berdekatan dengan bahagian ari-ari. Okay, boleh saya teruskan? Okay, once you get the permission, and you ask the patient to bring down the pen until the mid thigh. Boleh bantu turunkan seluar ke ke paha, then ask patient to bring down. Okay, so make sure that patient is in anatomical position. So what do you mean by anatomical position? Hand should be in what we call this one, in supine or prone supination, right? Okay, then you roll the clothes. Then this one, usually in exam patient is wearing kain, but if no kain, make sure there's a blanket you keep until here. Okay, so imagine patient has huge inguinal scrotal swelling on the right side. Okay, then you check. Okay, and then you tell the examiner, okay, on inspection, there's a huge swelling noted over the right scrotal area. It measuring around 10 by 10 centimeter in size. There's no skin changes noted. There's no ulceration. There's no redness. There's no surgical scar as well noted. Okay. As compared to the left side, there's no swelling noted. I can see there's obvious inguinoscrotal junction over the right side as compared to the left side. Okay, there's no other swelling elsewhere. Once you finish your inspection, right, you can palpate the patient, the swelling. Okay, of course, before you palpate, definitely you need to wash your hand before. Okay, you start palpating. Okay. Boleh saya pegang sikit ada mana-mana sakit? Kalau sakit bagi tahu. Okay. Then you palpate. Okay. So you stabilize on the left side. Okay, perfect. Okay, on palpation, the swelling is measured 15 by 10 centimeter in size. If you have a measuring tape, this time you can try to measure in two dimension. Okay, based on my measurement, this is okay. Show the to the examiner. 15 by 10 centimeter in size. Okay, is firm or soft in consistency. Okay, I can feel the testis at the back of the swelling. Lift up the swelling. There's no any local complication or ulceration at the back or posterior part of the swelling. I cannot feel similar swelling on the left side, but the testis on the left side is normal. Also on the right side is also normal size. Okay, now I'm trying to get above the swelling. When I insert my index finger just behind the inguinal scrotal junction, I try to pinch between my thumb and also my index finger. These two fingers cannot meet up, meaning that I cannot get above the swelling. In the case of hydrocel or testicular tumor, if I repeat that, right, definitely my fingers and my thumb can meet up, meaning that it indicates that the swelling is from below. If let's say the swelling comes from above, definitely I'm pressing on the hernia. It's from below, definitely I can palpate that. You can hear some what we call this one, the bowel sound. You can hear that sometimes. Then you mentioned to the examiner, when I try to examine or palpate the swelling, I can hear a bowel sound, indicating that maybe the content is bowel, or small bowel. Okay. Then if you can, listen to the bowel sound during by using your stethoscope. Once you finish that, Encik boleh minta tolong kasih hilangkan. Kasih masukkan, then you ask the patient to masukkan. Okay, then just imagine patient masukkan and it disappear. Okay, sir, the patient is able to reduce or make the swelling disappear, indicating that this is most likely inguinal or indirect inguinal hernia. Understand? Never ever you yourself use your hand to push it in. Make sure you let the patient to reduce it by himself. The moment it disappear, okay, you can ask the patient maybe to cough one more time to again confirm this is the hernia. You know that the classic appearance of hernia is positive cough impulse. Okay, usually when they cough, it protrudes slightly, then you show to the examiner this. So the swelling is it disappears, and also there's positive cough impulse, making that the diagnosis of inguinal hernia is very likely. Okay, now you go into examination of the deep ring occlusion test. This is very important examination. Okay, if let's just example that patient has right side hernia, what should you do is first you need to find the landmark. If on the right side, come nearer. Okay, on the right side, what should you do is okay, first you find the umbilicus. You sweep your hand laterally. First bony prominent that you feel, this is anterior superior eye-like spine. And then you use another hand, you sweep. Okay, go go inferiorly. First bony prominent that you feel, it is anterior symphysis pubis. and then you go lateral to it, to the ipsilateral side. This is pubic tubercle. Now you have an imaginary line between ACIS and also pubic tubercle. Okay, you find the line. Okay, and then you go two finger breadth above. This is right-sided hernia. You want to show to the examiner the positive cord impulse. So the best is you use left hand. Okay, what should you do is, you know that this is the midpoint of the inguinal ligament, kan? Then you go a bit up. Okay, use your thumb. Okay, to occlude. Okay, by doing this, you have a better space to show to the examiner when it comes up. Encik, boleh minta tolong batuk? Example, it doesn't come out. Okay, so it indicates that this is not a direct inguinal hernia. You know that, right? Direct, indirect inguinal hernia, the hernia comes out through the hyoscyamic triangle. So even if you close, you occlude the deep ring, definitely it doesn't give any effect. Okay? Okay, so you occlude, nothing coming out, this is not direct inguinal hernia. Okay, how to confirm that? You release your thumb. Ask the patient to cough again. Boleh batuk sekali lagi? Batuk. Suddenly it comes out. So it confirm your finding that this is indirect inguinal hernia. What about the left side? Same thing. If left side, you find your umbilicus, the patient's umbilicus, go lateral. First bony prominent that you feel. Okay. This is anterior superior iliac spine. And then you find pubic tubercle. Okay. Umbilicus, you palpate down. First bony prominent is symphysis pubis. Go lateral to it, to the ipsilateral side. Make imaginary line, two finger breadth above it, and then you occlude the deep ring. Okay, you ask the patient to cough. Remember just now, this is left side. I change the hand. You imagine if this side, I use this hand. Do you think the examiner can see? No. So I change hand. Okay. Understand? So there are two point here, that you need to memorize. Okay, the point that we occlude just now, this is what we call as midpoint of inguinal ligament. Okay, it indicates deep ring, isn't it? Right, deep ring. What about the other point? Mid inguinal point. What is mid inguinal point? Where is mid inguinal point? Indicates what? Femoral palm. So, it's imaginary line between what and what? SCIS and also pubic symphysis. Okay. So, find pubic symphysis. Just some pubic tubercle. This is pubic symphysis. The imaginary line over here. So, this align when we examine the femoral palm. Okay. Once you finish with the examination of the in supine position, you may end your examination by asking the patient to stand up. There are three things that you need to see when the patient is in standing position. Number one is you want to look for whether the patient has giant inguinal hernia. By definition, is giant inguinal hernia is in standing position, the inguinal the hernia goes down beyond the mid thigh. Okay, this is giant inguinal hernia. Why giant inguinal hernia is important? Because the management is more extensive as compared to normal inguinal hernia. Okay, number two, we want to see the contralateral side. Sometimes in supine position, we can only see one side only. But in standing up position, we can see another side is also affected. So we want to see the bilaterality. Number three, we want to observe for on the left side. We want to look for varicocele. By definition or by examination, varicocele is defined as when you palpate the swelling, it will feel like a bag of worm. Okay. Most of the time, varicocele will happen on the left side. We will ask you why it happened on the left side. There's a few things, four or five reasons behind that. Okay, done.